Full guard.
Y'all are going to want to be
captive audience. All right. So we're here. Today we're going to work on, since we have guerrilla warfare coming up, and not this Saturday, but next, we're going to work some basic submission defense. Armbar, triangle, Kimura, butterfly. Or omoplata. So we're here. Boom. All right. Basic defense 101. Don't get there. Great class, ready for it. All right. Couple things to be aware of. One, there's a center line right from the tip of Austin's nose right to the tip of his cup. Your arms don't cross those. This arm does not go across the cup. This arm does not go across this cup. That's never, I've never taught you, hey, and then you reach crossbody to do something really hard. So you never want to be that. And you never want to let him be the one who dictates how we're off center. So when we talk about, hey, I'm going to open and we're going to off center this way, right? My choice. What we never want to have happen is Austin shift his hips. And he dictated that. So I want to keep my hips square to his hips until I'm ready to address the problem, right? So it's also a little bit of, I have to control the pace, I have to control the position. The other thing is posture. Realize very rarely am I going to tell you guys to bury your head down here and be down there. The only time you do that is if you think you're going to pass out, you need to breathe for a second. It's a really bad way to breathe, but get here. And hold on, because there's not a lot they can do to you there. You can breathe for a second. That's only if you're about to pass out. Don't ever do that otherwise. But the basics of it is you want to control the positioning as much as possible. But let's assume Austin doesn't suck at jiu-jitsu. He's going to get to an armbar, right? Boom, he pulls the armbar. One. Early realism, as long as, the earlier you notice that Austin is attacking this arm, the better your life is going to be, right? So realize, no one's ever just grabbed an arm, shifted their hips out, and got done this to then do anything polite or nice to you. So when they start to shift their hips there, first thing we're going to do is we're going to connect this hand to our opposite bicep. As soon as his leg comes over, we're going to look to stack Austin and all of our weight on the back of his neck here. Now, I like to scoop his head. Some people will show you just to bring your hand up. Both are right, both are wrong, depending on the situation. I prefer scooping the head because it gives me more control, right? This is also right for defending this arm well. It just depends on your preference. Now, when I'm doing this, I'm going to stack Austin up on his neck, and I'm going to post my foot behind his butt. Reason I do that is, if not, Austin's just going to shift his legs out, boom, take the belly down armbar, right? We've worked that before. So boom, Austin swings up. I don't like that. I protect my arm. I kickstand. Now, once I get my weight on Austin, my weight does not leave over Austin's knees until my arm is out. Everything stays on top of this until the arm's out, right? So I'm here. My hands are woven, right? If you are going to grab up here, I like to pull this leg out a little bit. Once we're here, little motions with our elbow till it beats the hip line. Once it beats that hip, I like to grab that thigh, bring Austin down, and pass the guard. So we're here. Austin swings up for the armbar. I start to recognize that early. I start to weave my hands. Boom. Grab that thigh or grab that head. I kickstand Austin up. I keep all my weight down here to slowly, almost like a ratchet where you're kind of pulling it, little motions there. That's what you're looking to do. As soon as that arm escapes, push the legs past the guard. Questions on this? This is one of those definitions of simple but not easy.
Can I see it from the other side? So I see
it. Oh. Okay, we're here. Austin swings. Here. I stack all that weight down on top of it. And I keep the weight down while I'm releasing that heat. Once those hands up out,
push those legs past.
side control, reverse side, wherever you land is fine. But that's what you're looking for. Does that make sense? Bigger than me actually helps with this because their weight's going to be swinging that direction if they're hitting their arm bar. So if I'm here and Mr. Hensley comes here, right? Mr. Hensley's slightly bigger than me, right? I'm big and sexy, but he's bigger and sexier, right? So that'll happen, right? But Mr. Hensley still has to swing his legs up, which will still allow me to hit that. Like, his size doesn't impede this. It does make it more difficult, don't get me wrong. Will not stop you from doing what you're supposed to do. Biggest thing here is when you stack, you have to have control of something, whether it's the head or this leg. Because if not, all Jeremy's going to do if he's bigger and stronger is extend. So you have to defend this hand quickly and then work to get out. Once you're there, like I said, push that knee down past the legs. Questions on that?
I know in gi sometimes some people just have freakish grips where they'll just get a hold of your gi grip, even if you have a leg stack and they're not letting you down. Like, would you at that point go from the other side because then you could at that point stack on that?
So, just make sure I'm hearing you correctly. Well, he comes here. He's set to just a nasty grip, right? And you just can't get this out. Yeah, at that point, I'm still pulling this down and walking to that side. Because all you have to do is beat your elbow past his hips. Because my elbow's past his hips, right here. Like, my elbow is out right now. Extend your arm, finish the armbar. Once your elbow's out, you're out of trouble. So at that point, all you have to do is wait for the mistake.
You're just attacking the same side, though.
Yeah, I'm still attacking the same side. Very rarely am I going to push to this side. Mainly because if I do have to start trying to pass this side, it feeds that belly down. That's why I'm always going to stack here and look to pass this way. Does that make sense? I don't want to feed that belly down arm bar if I don't have to. Now, there's going to be times where he forces it and you got to play the action. But when possible, you want to control that outcome. Make sense? Other questions? So, technique one. Don't let him get there. Right? Smart ass answer. Bar. Realize controlling, staying in good position is the number one way not to get submitted. If you stay in a solid position with good posture, your hands where they're supposed to be, arm barring you or submitting you in really any way starts to become more and more difficult, right? So always focus on staying in good position, keeping good posture. Step two is they're better or they got there. How to defend that arm. Stack. Little motions, pass to that side. Questions? 1, 2, 3. Drill our ass. We're here. Boom. Once again, triangle defense in one step. Don't let them get there. Right? Ready, break. All right. Triangle defense, we're going to break down into a couple different places because sometimes triangles get there quickly. Sometimes it takes a second. So we're going to work on early and late triangle defense. All right? So, obviously, triangles are a very simple technique. One way, easy way to beat them is both hands in or both hands out from the legs. Realize the second you are one hand in, one hand out, you're just giving him a triangle with extra steps on his part. So always remember that. Like, when you feel jammed, because most triangle setups are not as sneaky as people think. They're going to pull one hand, push the other, jump their hips, right? Like, that is, at the white and blue belt level, 70% of triangles start like that. Is Jeremy's going to pull this arm, push that arm, boom, right? And jump to that triangle. Now, this is what I call early triangle defense, right? Jeremy's attempting a triangle right now, but realistically, it's not in yet. There's not a lot going on here. So I'm not in particular danger as of this moment. But if I don't address the problem very quickly, I'm going to be in trouble, right? So first thing we're going to do, the arm that is still in, I'm going to collapse that elbow straight to his hip, here. As I collapse that to the hip, I'm going to walk my knees right under his butt, here, and I'm going to look right where the ceiling meets the wall. I don't want to look at the ceiling, I don't want to look at the floor, because he's going to be trying to break my posture and pull my head down. So I want to keep my head up, my chest up here, right? So I'm looking right where that ceiling meets the wall. Collapse this elbow down. Now, as we get here, all we're going to look to do, this hand's going to come to the top of the knee, We're going to look to mage with our other hand here, just with the simple monkey grips, right? Pop and pop. As we do that, I'm going to drive my hips forward and posture my chest up. As we do that, obviously the guard is broken. Boom. Pass the legs past. Boom. So we're here, like I talked about, early triangle defense is just, with all submissions, it's the earlier you can read the sub, the easier it is to defend. How many of you guys are just blown away by the fact that you can't sub me most of the time, right? You'll be like, oh my God, I thought I had that armbar. No, I saw it 2 steps ago, and I knew how to defend it. We just rolled, right? The guard pass you hit. How complete did you think that guard pass was about to be?
I was like, oh shit, and then it went away really quick.
Right? Because I anticipated. I was already a step ahead of you. So the earlier you can be a step ahead, the easier your life tends to be, right? So boom, Jeremy starts grabbing grips and pushing and pulling. I know what's coming, right? So boom, he does that. Boom, I get my head up. Boom, collapse this elbow down. I get to this defensive position, right? I'm defending right now. Now we're going to work to escape. Hand comes up. Hand comes up. Boom. Head up, chest up, drive our hips forward, right? As we drive that forward, boom, pass that leg through, work for side control. Now, JJ, what's the difference in between escaping and defending?
Escaping and getting to a better position.
Yes. What's defending, the basics of defending?
You don't get worse.
Yeah. Realize that a lot of us have the problem in submissions. We're really good at defending submissions, right? But we're not very good at escaping them all the time. That's what we're going to work on this week and moving forward. We've gotten really good at defending them, right? How many of you guys have been stuck in a sub and it's like, oh, he can't finish this, but I'm stuck, right? How many of you have been stuck in that type of position? That's what we're going to be working our way out of, right? It's not just being able to defend a submission, it's being able to escape. Alright? So, that first triangle, head up, chest up, controlling those hips, getting into a better position. Questions on that?
If they pushed your arm across the center line, does this become goal and void, or do you still use this other
hand? Boom, you fight that hand back. Now, if you can't get that hand back, yes, null and void, we start going other places. But, even with your hand across, as long as it's not tucked in, start bringing it up, right? So like Jeremy starts to tuck this hand, I'm still gonna do all the other things, boom, and I may be able to still go back to that. Now, if he's already cut his angle and everything else has happened, yes, this becomes really null and void really quick, you gotta go other places, right? But like I said, that's why this is early triangle defense on this, where you still have some control over yourself at this point. Bop, head up, shuts up, pass. Mendoza.
I don't want to
good girl knees, but I can't have a super wide base here, right? Y'all knew exactly what I fucking meant, so don't laugh, right? So I don't want to have super wide base here, but I want to trap his hips. So like when I'm here with Jeremy, if I have a really wide base here, it's hard for me to get height. And Jeremy still has a lot of wiggle in his hips, right? I don't like that. So boom, I get here. See how Jeremy's hips are trapped in between my knees? That's where I want them, kind of just on the outside of his hip line, not completely pinched underneath them, because that makes me a liability just be swept. So like I said, you don't want good girl knees, but you want them pinching those hips. I'll laugh. That's exactly what I meant. And pop. Other questions on this one?
Stay with it. There you go. Way to stay with it.
All right, drill her out. 1, 2, 3. Alrighty, so we're here, right? Good things are happening, bad things are happening, life happens, right? Mr. Hensley's gonna go ahead and attack a triangle, right? Boom. He's gonna start really getting to crossing the arm over, right? This is all bad, right? None of this is gonna be good. So a couple things we wanna do defensively early. 1, this hand cannot stay across. Good, better. If we can tuck it. We're gonna start with good though, right? I just wanna get this back, even if he locks his triangle, right? Boom, I wanna get this elbow down, and I'm trying to almost peel this thigh and knee open with it. Keeping this hand tight so that it doesn't get armbar. I'm not leaving it way out here. It's tight here. Once again, I get my head pressure. I get up here. Now, if Jeremy's already cut his angle a little bit, he's already trying to lock this triangle, this is going to get to be really hard. So, next step of what we're going to do. I'm going to look to step up on the side that my arm is still in. I'm going to look to stack Jeremy up, collapse this knee over, and posture my head out. So we're here, I collapse the hip. Step up, post this knee down. Now, does anyone see the fact that I'm in an omoplata right now? You have to escape this arm quickly. Otherwise, you are getting omoplata'd. Once you're there, settle into side, mount, wherever you can get to at that point. But not getting triangled is the first goal, not landing in mount. Does that make sense? Realize when you're in trouble, the best way to get out of trouble is get to a neutral position, not trying to get to a good one. I see way too many people like, oh, I was trying to defend the armbar by going to mount. How about you defend the armbar first? Let's start there, and then we'll worry about getting to mount later. So we're here. Jeremy starts to really trying to triangle the shit out of me. I don't appreciate that. Boom. Collapse that elbow. Get that head up, chest up a little bit. Boom. I'm here. Foot comes up. Knee on belly. Control that arm out. Falls on my phone. Right above your head. So, questions on that?
Are you gonna limp arm?
Yeah, I'm limp arm swimming that hand down. Because you don't want to, you can't leave that hand in or you're getting omoplata'd and I will laugh at you. Probably hit Carson.
How much does the knee discourage the omoplata?
Realize that knee pressure is what you're trying to discourage him from triangling you with. That knee pressure and driving that hips forward, I'm trying to crush you with that to make you let go of triangle. Pain compliance. If it hurts, it makes you stop doing what you're doing. Always a good thing to know. Other questions on this? There you go, there you go. All right, drill her out. One, two, three.